Hi everyone, welcome back to this tutorial on how to customize the Blazor Circular Gauge. I will show you how to customize the axes, add multiple axes, customize labels and ranges, and add multiple ranges to the circular gauge. First, I will open an existing Blazor application, where I already have a circular gauge with basic properties height and width. To learn how to get started with the Blazor Circular Gauge component, refer to the video linked in the YouTube card above. I will run this application to show the initial demo. Look here, the circular gauge is rendered. Now I will show you how to customize the axes of the circular gauge. Here, the axis line is rendered based on the theme color. Now, I would like to display the axis line in red and apply a background color to the gauge. To do that, I define the background property of the circular gauge axis and set an appropriate color. To change the axis line color, I define the circular gauge axis line style tag. And within it, I set the color property to red. I also customize the width of the axis line by setting the width property to 2 pixels. Look here, the specified colors are set to the background and axis line. The default start value of the gauge is 0 and the end value is 100. If I would like to set custom start and end values, I can use the minimum and maximum properties. To demonstrate, I set the minimum property to 50 and the maximum property to 250. Look at the demo now, the start value is 50 and the end value is 250. Next, let's see how to customize the ticks in the circular gauge. To customize the major ticks, I define the circular gauge axis major ticks tag. Inside it, I am going to customize the color, height, and width of the major ticks. So, I set the color property to red, the width to 3 pixels, and the height to 10 pixels. To set the intervals between the major ticks, I use the interval property and set it to 20. Similarly, I define the minor ticks of the circular gauge by defining the circular gauge axis minor ticks tag. I set the tick color to green, width to 2 pixels, and height to 5 pixels. I also set the interval to 10. Look now, the major ticks and minor ticks are customized in the specified colors, heights, widths, and intervals. Usually, the ticks appear closer to the axis lines. If you want to leave a space between them, simply use the offset property. To demonstrate, I set the offset property to 5 in both major and minor ticks. See now, the space between the axis line and ticks is 5 pixels. By default, the ticks are positioned inside the axis. Apart from this default position, they can also be positioned outside and across the axis. Let's see how to set the ticks outside. I set the position property to outside in the major ticks and in minor ticks. Checking the control now, the ticks are displayed outside the axis. Next, let's see how to customize the labels. Notice the labels are rendered in a straight manner. But now I would like to display the labels along the axis. For that, I just need to define the circular gauge axis label style tag and enable the auto angle property. You can see the labels are rendered along the axis. Here the labels are rendered according to the range and intervals specified. If I want to display custom labels, say for example, I want to add degrees Celsius along with the label, I can use the label format property. Let me demonstrate by setting the format property with the appropriate value. Here, value represents the data label. Look here, the labels are displayed as formatted. Imagine, when this axis makes a complete circle, the first and last labels overlap with each other. In such a situation, I can hide either the first label or the last label and display it as a smart label. To demonstrate, I set the start angle to 0 and the end angle to 360 to make the axis a complete circle. Now the label of 0 degrees and 360 degrees overlap each other. So, I plan to hide the label of 0 degrees. To do that, I define the hidden label property and set first as its value. You can see the first label is hidden here. The circular gauge renders in the clockwise direction by default. To render it in the anti-clockwise direction, I set the direction property to anti-clockwise. The labels are now rendered in the anti-clockwise direction. Next, you will see how to add multiple axes in the circular gauge. I add one more circular gauge axis tag and set the minimum and maximum properties. Check now, multiple axes are rendered on the circular gauge. So far, we have seen how to customize the axes in the circular gauge. Next, I will show you how to customize the ranges in the circular gauge. To demonstrate, let me first add a range by defining the circular gauge ranges tag. Within it, I have added a single range with the basic properties start value and end value. To know more about how to add ranges, refer to the Getting Started video attached in the description below. Look at the circular gauge rendered with the defined range. Here the range renders in equal width. If I want to display it in different widths along the axis, I can use the start width and end width properties. Let me demonstrate by setting the start width to 2 pixels and the end width to 20 pixels. See now, the width of the range increases along the axis. This variation in width can be paired with a different range color. To demonstrate, I change the range color to blue by setting the color property and set the opacity to 0.2. Checking the gauge now, the color of the range changed along with the axis. The default position of the range is inside the axis. Apart from this default position, the range can also be displayed in the outside, cross, and auto positions. Now, I will demonstrate the cross position. To do that, I set the position property to cross. Looking at the component now, the range is rendered across the axis. To customize the appearance of the range in a circular shape, I can set the rounded corner radius property. Before that, I will set the range position to default by removing the position property. To display the range in a circular shape, I set the rounded corner radius property to 5 pixels. Look now, the corners of the range are displayed with rounded edges. Finally, I am going to show how to create multiple ranges. To do that, I add two more ranges by adding two circular gauge range tags. I have set the start, end, and radius values to all the tags appropriately. Look at the component now, multiple ranges are rendered. In this video, you have seen how to customize the axes, add multiple axes, customize the labels and ranges, and add multiple ranges to the circular gauge. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please like it and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.